Hello friends, welcome to our channel Mechanical Motivator. Today we just going to see a basic problem on projection of solid. I will be explaining the question, then given data, then I will be telling how to draw the diagram step by step. A hexagonal prism of side base 30 mm. So the diagram what we going to draw is a hexagonal prism. The side is 30 mm and height is 60 mm. Rest with one of its base edge on VP. So resting will be VP. Another thing is orientation. Orientation they clearly mentioned that one of its base edge. So according to orientation, we will be having two things, right? One will be corner and another one will be edge. So it's a edge oriented one. Then its rectangular face is inclined at 45 degrees to VP. So what we are going to incline is rectangular faces. Sometimes they will be asking you to incline base edge or axis like that. In this question, we are going to just incline the rectangular face, then draw its projection. So this is what the given data. And thing is, there will be a confusion. What type of hexagon we are going to draw? So there are totally two types of hexagon. So one will be like this, and another one will be the second one. So in our question, they clearly mentioned as edge oriented one. So edge means this is the edge. So this one is the edge and this is the corner oriented. Okay. So when we are according to solids, we will be seeing from the right hand side. So in planes, we will be seeing from left hand side. But in solids, we will be focusing only on the right hand side. We will be seeing it from here. So edge means you have to focus here. Corner means you have to focus here. Likewise, we will be focusing. Now we will start the diagram. First step is we are just going to draw a reference line. XY and we VP should be above and HP should be below. As we decided earlier, we just going to go with the first diagram. So we'll be drawing the hexagon like this, and we know how to draw the hexagon. So base is like this. So this will be your base. For example, this will be your 30 mm, and then you will be taking 60 degrees 60 degrees. So you'll be taking 60 degrees like this. You'll be taking 60 degrees 60 degrees. So this angle will be 60 degrees, and then you will be drawing a straight line and straight line like this, and you will be taking 30 mm and will be cutting an arc, so that you will be getting a point here and just join it and just commit it. So hexagon, we know how to draw it, right? So actually you just follow as I mentioned and discussed in earlier videos. And here we are going to choose as the edge orientation as we discussed before. So this is the edge orientation one. So this will be your base, and here you have to take 60 degrees 60 degrees, and you have to draw a straight line. And then take for the 60 degrees, you have to draw a 30 mm 30 mm line, and from there you have to cut an arc. So we'll be completing the hexagon part completely. So just see here, this is a hexagon prism. This one will be alphabet top face, and this one will be bottom face. So hexagon is resting on VP. So this is VP. Hexagon will be resting. So here we'll be having alphabet, and here we'll be having numerical. So A B C D E F will be here, and 1 2 3 4 5 6 will be here. That's why when you see from front view, we are naming it as 1-2-. Oh, I did a mistake. Okay, actually, here why I did a mistake. It's actually. It's 2- and bracket B-. Yeah. Okay. So when we are seeing from a front view, we will be writing it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 will be easily visible, because numericals will be here, right? So this is numerical face and this is the alphabet face. So alphabets we can't see, that's why we are putting inside the bracket. So since it's a front view, we are putting it as dash. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 will be visible, and A, B, C, D, E, F won't be visible. So this is your front view, and you have to draw the base diagram here. And also one more hint we are having. Rectangular face is inclined to VP. So they are given rectangular face. If it's inclined to VP, means your base diagram should be in VP. Okay. Your base diagram should be in VP. And when we are seeing from the top, so this is the top view, right? Then we are going to draw the top view. When you are seeing from the top view, it's very easy for drawing it, because we have already given the height as 60 mm. So this is 60 mm. So here we'll be having alphabets. So top face will be the alphabets, and bottom face will be numerical. When you see from here, you can see A, but you can't see B. So only A inside B. You can see F, but you can't see C. So F into C. And you can see E, but you can't see D. That's why E inside B. Same thing for numericals also. So one you can see, but two you can't see. Likewise, if it means you will be naming here, the height of the text is 60 mm. We have just drawn the front view on top view. Now what we are going to do, we are just going to incline. This is the rectangular face. I am just going to incline this rectangular face for 45 degrees with respect to VP. So now we are just going to tilt this diagram. So we are going to incline the rectangular face 45 degrees to VP. So this is the rectangular face. Okay, this is the rectangular face. Even this is the rectangular face. You can incline anything. I am inclining this one. So this is the rectangular face. I am just going to incline it for 45 degree. What I am going to do is on the reference line, you keep a point and take just tilt your keep your protractor upside down and take 45 degree. You have to measure this. So this measurement is 60. So for 60 mm, you have to draw a line for 45 degree. Okay. So length of the line is 60 mm and angle is 45 degree. Then just measure this. Just measure this line and keep your protractor here. And for 90 degree, you draw this line. Then measure this line. You will be having some 3 or 4 centimeter. For 90 degree, perpendicularly, you have to draw this line. And finally, you can complete the box. What I'm going to tell you is, you're just going to replace this box here with the exact dimension. All the lines should be drawn perpendicular. You can use your L-shaped scale, or else you can use your protractor and draw 90 degree line and then mark the distance. The thing is, we're just going to replace this diagram here and we are tilting it for 45 degree and naming this as it is. So AB means it's A1, B1. Likewise, you have to name all the things. Here we'll be getting 3 points, 1, 2, 3, and here we'll be getting 3 points, 1, 2, 3. Just extend all the 6 points vertically above, and here we are having 1, 2, 3, 4 points we are having. Just extend all the 4 points horizontally. So this, so here we'll be having ABCD and here we'll be having 1, 2, 3, 4. So this A and this A will be meeting at this point. This B and this B will be meeting at this point. Like this, we have to just intersect. We have to identify the intersection of all the alphabet as well as numerical. So here we'll be having A, B, C, D. Here we'll be having 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm just going to mark the points. And then we'll be telling you how to draw the hidden line. And then we'll complete the diagram. Now we have just marked all the A, B, C, D alphabet points and as well as numerical points. Now we want to identify which is hidden. So just see here, after tilting this diagram, identify which edge or which corner is touching XY line or else which is nearer to XY line. So when we see from here, only this edge we can't see. So identify what all edges connected to it. For example, if this is the edge which is hidden, which is nearer to XY or on XY. So see here, E to F will be hidden and D to F. You have to pair like this. So E and F is one pair and D and F is one pair. Okay. So sorry, D and C. So it's C here. So E and F is one pair and D and C is one pair. And E and F I is one pair and D and 4 is one pair. So these are the only hidden. So just see here. So E to F means you have to draw like this. So hidden we can draw with yellow chalk so that it will be easy for you to identify. So E to F is hidden as well as E to D is also hidden. See here, E to D is hidden. So E to D is also hidden as well as D to C is hidden. D to C is hidden as well as E to 5 is hidden. So E to 5 is hidden here. And D to 4 is also hidden. Hidden lines can be drawn like this. Hidden lines, it's a continuous dash, you can draw like this. Hidden lines can be drawn like this. So only E to F is hidden. E to F is hidden. E to D is hidden. And D to C is hidden. E to 5 is hidden. And D to 4 is hidden. So just join remaining sides. So what are the remaining sides? I will start from 1 to 3 so that it will be very easy. So 1 to 2 is the edge. So this is the edge. 2 to 3 is the edge. 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 1. I have counted this. Then remaining is A, B, C, D. So A to B, B to C, C to D is hidden, D to E is hidden, E to F is hidden. So remaining is this one. So these things we have completed. Here we will be having one face. So this is one edge. See here, this is one face. Actually, E to 5 is hidden. But E to 1 is a edge. See here, E to 1 is a edge. So we have to draw a dark line. E to 1 is a edge. Same thing here also. D1 to 4-1 is hidden only. But D to 2 is a edge. So we have to draw. So we have to draw a edge here. And we have to complete it like this. See here, this is one face. So this will be on face. This is on face. This is on face. This is on face, and this is on face, and remaining only hidden. So I hope so. It's very clear what are things we have to hide it out, and what are edges we have to darken it. Always try to understand that edges, that is in a solid, out of a solid edge won't be hidden. So it will be very visible. So solid edge should not be drawn with the hidden lines. So these are all called the solid edges. So these should be clearly mentioned, and just see to it. For 90% problem, this hint will be helpful for you to complete the diagram. So after completing it, try to rub the what are the lines which are unwanted. So this is a solution. This solution should be drawn very darkly with your HB pencil. This box should be drawn with the HB pencil. The hexagon should be drawn with the HB, as well as the top view should be drawn with the HB. And naming, that is AB, like that, whatever things you are adding should be drawn with your HB. The extension line should be drawn with your 2H pencil. Dimensioning part, we have to dimension this side. This is 30 mm, and this is 60, height is 60, and angle is 45 degrees. Height of the deck should be projection of hexagonal prism. The height of deck should be 10 mm, and all dimensions are in mm scale. Only the one should be written with height of deck should be 5 mm. These two headings and subheadings should be written with your HB pencil. Do subscribe my channel Mechanical Motivator, then only you will be getting regular updates which whatever videos I upload. Thanks for watching this video. If you feel this video is useful, means you can share with your friends.